Show the day of the release.
I chase bad bitches, accolades, got Will son, no castaway. I'm twice as good, get half the praise. There was sniper up and out.
Hey guys, what's going on? Sander here. Today I wanted to bring you guys a little introduction into my solo world. I've been playing a lot of solos in Madden 16. The solos are really fun to me, and I've had a lot of fun doing them, and I've no way to get through them really fast. I wanted to share them with you guys. So first off, I want to go over team, because team is probably the most important part of this. Now, first off, you're going to want a good offensive line. Now, I do have an all-elite offensive line, but if you have all golds, that's fine. I have like 85 overall backups for all these guys. Like, this is the best run blocking left tackle in the game. What's his run block? 94. Or best run blocking for golds. I have all the best run blocking gold backups. What, we got Leary, what's his run block? 95. Those are who I'd get. They're around a couple thousand coins each. Anyways, we got Kelsey. I just had him. 94 run block. Yeah, again, all my backups are good, but I don't even use them. I could sell them for coins, but I'll get to why I have them, like, all my golds later. Now, the two best run blocking tight ends. Those are good for toss plays, which I will also get into later. And Julius Thomas, in case I need to throw. Now, quarterback-wise, I got Winston just because he has good deep ball, his great throw power, and then Tyrod Taylor in case I ever want to run with him, but I haven't really done that lately. Also, if you guys have not checked out my video, I'm giving away a Tyrod Taylor. That's why I have two of them. He's a great quarterback. He goes for around 20K right now. Price could probably go up a bit. So if you want to enter that, go check out my last video to see how to win that. Now, Dre Archer. Now, I'm sure most of you have seen Dre Archer before. You get him from completing, I believe, one of the first couple journey solos. Dre Archer, a monster. If you don't have him, if you don't do the journey solos, you'd always just buy him for a couple hundred coins on the block. 96 speed, not much more to say there. Now, fullback. I don't know. I mean, you could always just put a tight end, like the good run blocking tight ends here. That's fine. I'd have to work, that'll get the job done. But from one of my elite packs I got from the solos, I got Anthony Sherman. So he has 97 run block, so he just pancakes everyone when I run toss plays. And now to the receivers. Second receiver, doesn't really matter. I just use Odell because I got him from, yet again, another one of those. I actually got him from the Draft Champ. Or no, I got Odell from the Journey, and I got Anthony Sherman from Draft Champions. Kelvin Benjamin, no really purpose, just good catch in traffic. Odell, good catch. Like, they're possession receivers. If I need someone to catch the ball, they'll be there. I know I can throw it to them, and they'll get it. Now, here is probably the biggest part of this entire offense. Breshad Perriman. 97 speed. Not a single person in the game can cover this man. Literally, just put him on a streak, and if they're in cover three, it is a guaranteed touchdown every time. That's why I have Jameis Winston with the good throw deep and all that, because he puts the ball on the money. To be 100% honest, I actually think Tyrod Taylor threw the ball a little better than Jameis did. I don't know. I might just sell Jameis. I haven't finished the journeys. I just bought this Jameis because I wanted to see how he played, because he had better stats all around except for speed mainly. So that's that. Now, defense. Defense doesn't really matter. I'm not good on defense. I would just say get who you want. My corners are okay. I feel like corners, unless you have, like, you know, 95 overall corners, which they don't even have yet, it's just too hard to keep up with half the guys. Like, especially when even the Ravens in the solo challenges with Breshad Perriman, my guys just get burned every time. Then D-line, as you see, I kind of just, my edge, I got Michael Bennett, and then I got, what is it, Randy Gregory, I believe? Yeah, okay, Randy Gregory. They bring speed off the edge, and then I got just two run stuffers in the middle, just big fatty patties. That was the weirdest thing I've ever said in my life. But then we got Star Lutalele and Vince Wilfork there, so they'll clog up the middle for the run game, make them go to the outside, and then we got Gregory and Bennett out there. Then we got Sean Gibson. I don't know why. He's been playing pretty good for me. I just like how he plays. He doesn't make crazy stats, but he has really good zone, and he doesn't get beat deep a lot because of that. So that's what I like about him. Then I got George Ioka. I got him for free. Can't sell him, but I don't want to sell him. He has great stats all around the board. Probably one of the best safeties in the game, and does not go for a lot. Now, my linebacking core, I'm not going to change a single thing about it. I could buy better ones, but why would I want to? We got Michael Kendricks, 15K, 88 speed, 89 hit power. I'm not even going to say anything more. That's all you need. Anthony Barr, 6'5", 91 speed. All you have to say. And we got Dante Hightower, which I actually got from an all-pro pack that I got from Journey Solos before I was using Sean Lee. But Sean Lee compared to Dante. Yes, it's Dante. I always want to call him Dante. Dante Hightower. Dante Hightower is just better all around the board. So, but I'll probably sell him when the elite prices go back up. So that's that. Then Specialist doesn't really matter. I have Philip Dorsett, 96 speed in there. Marquette King, got him from a pack. Just doesn't really matter. So yeah, now I'm going to go over a couple plays you're going to want to run. First off, I'm going to show you my playbooks. You can use whatever playbooks you want, really. These are just what I'm rocking right now. Bengals defense, Eagles offense. Eagles offense is just fun for me to use when I don't want to like try against the solos. You know, I just want to chill back around like the option and stuff. Find that fun every once in a while to, you know, change it up. But overall, what you're going to want to run inside of the solos is go into the goal line formation in your playbook and just go to strong toss. I'm almost certain every single playbook will have that. And just run it. And all of, that's why you're going to want the blocking tight ends, the blocking fullback, because all of them are out on the field in goal line. And it just, they just plow through everything. The corners can't stand, like Anthony Sherman against the fullback, or against a corner, excuse me there, he will plow through everyone. There's no one, there's not a single corner in the game that's going to withstand him blocking him. They just fall and get pancaked automatically. And then usually the tight ends will hold up pretty good on their own. Now, with Breshad Perriman, what I want to do if for the journeys, especially where it's like you have 20 seconds to go get a touchdown, just run him on a streak route. If it's cover three, which for you guys who don't know, there will be one safety in the middle of the field. And then the two corners will be, you know, on like manned up on the outside receivers. You're going to want to run Breshad Perriman on a streak. And then you're going to put your tight end. I would suggest doing this in single back formation. So you have two receivers or one receiver on each side, a tight end on each side of your line. And then you have one back in the backfield. And then run Breshad Perriman on a streak. And then you're going to want to put the tight end on that side on a streak as well. And what's going to happen is the corner is going to have to pick between one or the other. And it's not even the fact, even if he does pick Breshad Perriman, by the time the CPU realizes which one they want to cover, Breshad Perriman is already 10 yards past him. So it's basically a point where if the quarterback can put the ball in the right spot, which most of the time happens. So that's how I've been doing some solos. I'm not the best at solos. I'm not even done with Journey, so I'm not the best to talk, but Journey solos do get pretty hard now to where I'm at. I'm at 117 and counting. I haven't really done any Gauntlet or style just because I feel like NFL Journey is going to be the hardest out of all of them. Gauntlet, I mean, I guess, but by the time I get to Gauntlet, I have so many elites from doing all these. And this is just in general the most time consuming, so I want to get this out of the way because I know I'm not the only one who wants to get to Mutt Grant, was it Mutt Master? And I want to get that 99 overall Odell Beckham, which is why I am saving all my gold cards. I'll show you guys right now. I have a lot of high overall golds, which I could probably sell for 150K if I sold all my golds. They're all high overall golds. Now, yes, as you can see, some of them in my lineup. But most of these cards are just, they're just here. I'm not using any of them. And I could sell them, probably get over 100K easily. But I'm not going to try to sell them. Because when I do get to the Mutt Master, some of these cards, yeah, I can sell them now for 10K, but then what? I'm just going to have to buy it back for 10K later. So it's just overall better for me to save my coins and save my players now. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more. This is how to get better at solos and beat solos in Madden 16. So leave a like and subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys in the next.